Hi, my name is Arvind Suthar with the Identity Engineering Get to Production team here at Microsoft, and I'm here today to talk to you about Azure AD B2B. I'll provide you with an overview of the capabilities, a walkthrough of the admin and the end user experiences, some benefits of these capabilities, and some new enhancements in Azure AD B2B. So what is Azure AD B2B? Azure AD B2B enables companies to simply and securely collaborate with external users. Let's see why. One way to share access to resources in your company is to create a new username and password for the person you're sharing with. There is no connection between this new account and the account that person uses to log in at their own company. This means that when a person loses access to their own company's resources, they still have access to yours. Another way to share access to a resource in your company with someone outside your company is to simply email it to them. There is no connection between the data that you have shared and the data you maintain in your organization. That data can get out of date, be modified, or redistributed. It is now out of your control. Azure AD B2B solves both problems. A stub account is created in your directory to represent the user you're sharing with. If the user goes away, the stub account in your directory becomes unusable. So what kind of accounts can you share with? Definitely accounts at other companies using Azure AD is built-in capability. You can also share with Microsoft accounts. These are consumer accounts like Hotmail or Live.com accounts. We also support federation with Gmail accounts if the admin sets up Google Federation. And any account from an identity provider that supports SAML or the WSFed protocol. And if none of those work, we can use emailed one-time passcodes to authenticate any user with an email address. So how do we invite these external users? Azure AD B2B is built into most Microsoft products, as well as the Azure portal. You can invite external users from your own applications using the Graph API. You can also enable external users for self-service access using entitlement management. This diagram shows the precedence rules used when determining which account to use when a user is redeeming a B2B sharing invitation. You can read more about that at this link. One nice thing about Azure AD B2B is that partner users act as standard users in many ways. You can assign them to apps the same way, and they can use the access panel to access the apps you've shared with them. You can use security groups and conditional access policies to control access from external users. Earlier, I mentioned entitlement management as a way to enable self-service for your external users. Entitlement management allows you to delegate the ability to create access packages to business owners in your organization. Access packages wrap up the resource, who can request access, how long that access lasts, and who is responsible for reviewing that access. Access packages then become available in the access panel for your external users to request access to. Let's take a look at the basic Azure AD B2B admin and end user experiences. We have four personas here. Two are internal to Woodgrove Bank, an IT admin Rabindra, and a project lead April. Two are external to Woodgrove, a corporate IT vendor, Arvin, that's me, with an Azure AD account, and a self-employed vendor, Hector, with a Gmail account. For Rabindra to enable Google Federation, he will need to configure a client ID and client secret at the Google website and enter that information in the All Identity Providers panel under the External Identities blade in Azure AD. For Rabindra to require MFA and a Terms of Use acknowledgement for external users, he will need to configure a conditional access policy under the conditional access panel in the Enterprise Applications blade in Azure AD. And Rabindra can now invite Arvind from the user's blade in Azure AD. Arvind gets an email in his corporate inbox inviting him to Rabindra's directory. He accepts the invitation and is prompted to accept terms of use and configure MFA. And now Arvind has access to the access panel. But Azure AD is not just for admins. April is a project manager who wants to invite Hector to collaborate on a project in Teams. She is able to invite his Gmail account directly from the Teams interface. Hector receives an invitation in his Gmail inbox and is able to sign in using his Gmail credentials. He consents to Woodgrove being able to sign him in using his Gmail credentials and is prompted for terms of use and to configure MFA. And now Hector can collaborate with April in Teams. Let's dig into the benefits of using Azure AD B2B. There are five of them: single sign-on, the ability to share with any user, governance capabilities, the ability to share any app, and the ability to secure access in Teams. So single sign-on, more secure, simpler to administer, easier to use. These are the promises that single sign-on has promised us for some time. Azure AD brings the simplicity of single sign-on without the complexity traditionally associated with identity federation. So terminated users automatically lose access to your resources. The fact that these users are using their standard, normal, everyday accounts to access your resources reduces the likelihood and the duration of compromise of their accounts. This is also simpler to administer because you, as a resource administrator, resource admin, you don't need to keep track of people from other organizations, if they're still employed, if they still should have rights to your resources. There's no passwords to manage, there's no accounts to store, and your users from other organizations don't need to remember another password, which is simpler for everybody. As mentioned before, Azure AD B2B works for any user. So this means even if your partner doesn't have an Azure AD account, you can still share with them. You can use direct federation to support users that are authenticating with ADFS or third-party identity providers, even if those users don't have Azure AD. As we talked about, you can use Google Federation for users that have a Gmail account, but perhaps no corporate credentials. And you can use one-time passcodes to share with anybody who can receive an email. In terms of governance, the same governance methods that are available to employees can also apply to external users. Sometimes external user management isn't as tightly governed as internal user management. And so Azure AD B2B lets you use the same mechanisms for both: conditional access, multi-factor authentication, security groups, terms of use. All of these can apply to both populations of users. Risk-based policies are also possible for external users. So we have heuristics that can determine the riskiness of a sign-in. You can apply policies to allow or deny access based on the risk associated with external user accounts as well. You can use groups managed on-prem to control what external users can access as well. We showed you terms of use. Those terms of use can be prompted for during invite redemption. Also, periodically, you can require re-acknowledgement of those terms of use. And then entitlement management and the automation of self-service, we mentioned that before. These capabilities can apply to your internal as well as your external users. And all changes to your settings are logged in the audit log. So you have a well-governed access from your external users. Any app. So these apps that are being protected, they don't need to be authenticating against Azure AD in order to be protected by Azure AD. You can publish legacy apps using app proxy. So apps that are using Windows authentication, forms based off, header based off, apps hosted behind a remote desktop gateway. All of these applications can be published by app proxy and protected by Azure AD conditional access. Similarly, applications that you may have that are using third parties like Akamai, Citrix, F5, or Zscaler can be protected by Azure AD using our secure hybrid access capabilities. So these users, if they're external users, the one caveat here is they need to be populated on premises. And we have some articles here as to how you can do that to enable your on-premises applications to be protected when they're published to external users. And finally, Teams. Collaboration in teams is happening more and more, especially during these times. Many customers have concerns about allowing external access to teams. Blocking teams' access to external users is just going to make people use another less secure method to get that data to the people that need it to do their jobs. And so you're going to have people emailing documents or having rogue IT, shadow IT, box accounts out there. You really want to have any sharing that happens happen in a way that you can manage and monitor. So here's our best advice for governing access in teams. Have the team's owners agree that governed external collaboration is a good thing. And so you can set all of your team's instances to have external sharing disabled by default. Notification to central IT or a request to central IT can happen when you want to enable a team for external sharing. And then central IT can set up access reviews on those teams. And we have to be sure not to add any users directly to the underlying SharePoint Online site that underlies the teams. Then for each team that's requested for external sharing, central IT can enable external sharing on that team, enable access reviews on that team, and create access review on that team. And then on an ongoing basis, central IT can monitor that access reviews are happening and that no users are being added outside of the governed method of access reviews, and no users are being added directly to the SharePoint Online site. So this is a good approach to making sure that all of your team's access has someone looking to see that everybody external to your organization that has access should have that access. All right, so we've talked about what Azure AD B2B is and what are the benefits. Let's talk about three new capabilities in Azure AD B2B. One is sovereign cloud availability. So we've gone general availability with Azure AD B2B in China and in our US government clouds. So that's good news for your business if you do business in China or you do business with the US government and need to have that sovereign cloud capability for collaboration. Second, we have the ability to invite internal users. So this is taking, many companies do business already with this method of provisioning accounts for your external users because B2B wasn't always there. And so there is a legacy of external collaboration happening with accounts that you manage. Inviting external users gives you a path to migrating those users to partner-managed identities, to Azure AD B2B. And you can read more about how to do that at the link. Finally, we're bringing together Azure AD B2B and Azure AD B2C to give you more flexibility in how your users sign in and sign up, and also give you more programmability as well. And there's some details at the link. We'll talk a little bit about what's in public preview now. So external identities, which is now in public preview, allows your external users to have self-service sign-up capabilities. A new feature is allowing those users to sign up with their Facebook accounts, not just their Google accounts. You have custom workflows, which enable you to collect information from those users at sign-up time. A cool feature of external identities is our API connectors. So you can have your own code that gets called when a user signs in successfully and right before that user account is created in your directory. These API connectors can be used to implement approval workflows, override data, augment data being added to the user from external sources. So it provides a lot of extensibility. And user flows allow you to customize the signup experiences, add custom attributes, determine which attributes are collected from the user at sign-in. And you know, through the API connectors, you have the full power of the Microsoft Identity Platform and Microsoft Graph. So in the future, we hope to show you some details about how you can use external identities to configure these experiences and what those experiences look like for your users. I hope this discussion of Azure AD B2B has been helpful to you. Thanks very much for listening.